So pay attention, in today's lecture we discussed about bleeding time and clotting time. So what is bleeding time? What is the definition of bleeding time?
Time
taken or onset of bleeding to stop of bleeding is called as bleeding time. Okay, what is the normal bleeding time?
1 to 3 minutes.
Increased bleeding time is seen in
decreased
platelet count, right? So what will be the bleeding time status in case of internal bleeding? Bleeding time will increase in internal bleeding, okay? Because of platelet count will be decreased. Okay? Then what are the clinical significance of bleeding time? Before surgery, to know the before transplantation, to check the purpura condition, and also in some viral fevers there will be decreased platelet count. Okay? And also there are some diseases such as Bartter disease, Gassman's thrombocythemia and Bender Sawyer syndrome where there will be dysfunction of platelets resulting in increased bleeding time. Okay? Then clotting time. What is the normal clotting time? 4 to 6 minutes. And what is the definition? It is the conversion of liquid state of blood to serous solid state, or in the formation of fibrinogen is called as clotting time. So clotting time will increase in absence of any clotting factor. What is the disease?
Hemophilia.
Hemophilia A and B, factor 9. And this is also used to assess patients under warfarin therapy or anticoagulant therapy. In patients who are under warfarin therapy, clotting time should increase to check the status of clotting, okay, anticoagulants. Okay, that's it. Also in patients that have problems of DIC. What is the full form of DIC? Very good. Then coming to the methods of detection of bleeding time and clotting time, what are the three methods of bleeding time?
Fingerprint
method, IV method. So fingerprint method is commonly used method. And what method we will use here now? In what method we will use blood pressure cuff?
IV
method. And methods of clotting time, what are the two methods?